today, we've got
Ryan Boyce. In real estate, whether it's buying, selling, flipping, what would you say your most favorite part of this business is?
Helping my people I genuinely love either get out of a tough situation by selling their house or helping them find their house because they're growing their family, it's their first house. Like watching them sign the papers and I get to just sit across the table, the sheer excitement and joy in their face, knowing that they're about to go into that house without me, without a home inspector, without a termite inspector, that it's they walk in and it's theirs, there's nobody else with them. Knowing that they have that feeling of staring at each other like, we did this,
yeah,
is probably one of the most beautiful things I can picture when it comes to real estate. And the other thing is knowing that some of these houses that were flipping, that there could have been really bad living situations that went on that will no longer go on in those houses. Hopefully, that we've provided a different environment for them.
What would someone that wants to get into real estate, okay, and what would be your maybe top two piece of advice for them?
Okay, so the one thing I told myself was no one is going to know my neighborhood or my area better than I am. And so what I did is I just started setting these little searches in my neighborhood, the neighborhood next to me, the neighborhood next to me. And I just would watch, okay, that house sold for this. That house, somebody bought this house for this, somebody sold this house for this. So I would know down to a science, hey, in Red Mill in Virginia Beach, the houses are going for, you know, $168 a square foot, between $300,000 and $350,000. Or the neighborhood next to it, okay, that one's selling for $400. Or the neighborhood next to it, those houses are between this and this. So when somebody asks, how's the market? Because that's the question. How's the real estate market? I would say, you know, it's great in each area. It depends on where you're at. And I would be able to speak about this neighborhood. And once I knew that neighborhood, I'd learn a new one. So I would study 1 to 2 hours daily, all these different neighborhoods. And so I may not have known everything that was inside of the house, but I could sure tell you how much houses were selling for strictly by studying. And by knowing that information, I quickly learned that the other agents weren't learning that stuff. They were learning what a vanity was.
Yeah.
They were learning what a shag carpet was, or Berber carpet, or granite countertops, because they were putting their studying into HGTV while I was studying each and individual market of foreclosures, short sales, flipped houses, new construction. So when I had a conversation with somebody, it wasn't, holy shit, you've only been in real estate 6 months. It's holy shit. This dude knows his stuff.
Yeah.
And I quickly got past the, you're brand new in real estate, there's no way I'm using you to sell my house, to there's no way I cannot use you to sell my house because you are a wealth of knowledge.
Let's talk marketing. As far as social media, ad campaigns, using it for real estate. I think that real estate agents, realtors, they don't really access this realm as much as they should. And I think that you do it so well, and it's something that you're very passionate about. Let's just talk. I'll just have it as an open platform for you.
Yeah, I know you're saying this because I can just go on this subject.
Really good.
It's to me, it's simple. You are going to buy a house. Maybe the statistic is once every 5 years, right? So to me, if I'm only capturing your attention once every 5 years, when that 5 years comes up, you're not gonna think of me. You're gonna think of whoever is the closest to you at that particular second that you see that sells houses. So to me, I don't wanna push open houses, and I don't wanna push, look at me, I'm Ryan Boyce who sells real estate down your throat, because who the hell wants to watch that? Nobody. I don't wanna watch it. I don't wanna see it. To me, I'd rather document the process of, hey, let's let's design this house together online. Or, hey, look at this shithole. Let's figure out how to get this thing looking good. Or, I'm a brand new buyer, what do I do? Well, I'd rather show somebody, okay, well, this is the process that you go through to buy a house. And if document, don't sell. So if I can record the process of showing, hey, we're a large family coming from not much to growing our business, our social media, our flipping, our real estate, our marketing, and I can document that process, then everybody is starting small. So if they can take these little tidbits of what we're doing in real estate and put them towards insurance or put them towards anything, selling cars, it could be a 9-to-5 job that they bring value to their company for. And if that's how we can show them through this process, then that's how it should be done. We should be documenting how we do things and engaging, not throwing up sales all over people's faces. Nobody wants it. You'll turn off and you'll unsubscribe, block, unfollow when it's look at me, check out, come to my open house. It just does not work.
Turn more family. Would you want your kids to come alongside and work with you in this journey?
Oh yeah. I want to be in my vacation properties. I want to be chilling on the beach. Now, what I want from my kids is I want them to do what they truly have a passion for, and I love that you said you want them to fail a little bit. I also want them to fail and struggle, and I want them not to think, hey, I've got to work for mom and dad. I've got to work, or I've got the family business. I don't want that to be looked at that way. I want them to go out into this world and do whatever they find happiness in. And if happiness looks like a 9-to-5 job for them in a cubicle, then I want that for them. Whatever they define as happiness is what they should go for. Is this door open for them and welcome for them to come in and hopefully find happiness in it? 100%. Because to me, you need to wake up and just be excited about waking up and what you're going to do. If you're waking up in the morning and you're pissed about going to work, well, then you need to stop doing that work immediately, because you got short term on this planet compared to the grand scheme of things. I hope we all get 100 years. I hope we all get 70, 80 years out of this planet. You never know. But even that is very short term in the grand scheme of things. So why waste time doing something you hate? I cannot stand that. And I think that moment in clarity came at Chick-fil-A when you're like, go for it. When you said go for it, it wasn't go for it in real estate, Ryan. It was go for it about your happiness, because that's obviously where it is. And with that happiness, there's no way you can fail.
Absolutely. Like, what would you say to somebody who might have seen you almost a decade ago to someone that's looking at you now?
That was crazy. I mean, it was. I mean, look, I think I'm so thankful to be a recovering alcoholic. Yeah, sorry. I think one of the reasons is, and why it's so fresh still, is we all are going to have a dark, dark time. It's bound to happen. There's no way. God, if you're one of those 1% that can live in this life and never have a struggle, good on you.
No.
But that's not most. And whether people have depression, anxiety, whether it's alcohol, whether it's addiction, whether it's divorce, whether it's abuse, we all got it. We all, at some point, it will affect us. And because it affects us, it's those moments that truly define who you're going to be. And when I was an alcoholic, it was so selfish that I didn't really realize the beauty in people until afterwards. It took struggling, hitting rock bottom, and being basically an addict and alcoholic to realize the true beauty in other people that were in my life. And without that, I would have never seen it. And because of being able to become sober, it made me realize, God, there's truly people who love me around me, and there's truly people who have my best interests at heart. And God, what can I do to help them and give that back to them? Because if it wasn't for them, then I would never have that chance of being sober. And they wouldn't, and for the people that believed in me when I was in those dark places, how can I give back to them? Like I did a story on Instagram about a week ago. And I truly mean it when I say that I love real estate. I love baseball. Those are like my two huge passions. But I will stop both of them in the drop of a second to get somebody sober, to give them some advice that'll allow them to move forward in their journey. In a second, I will do it. And I think just having that experience of struggling and being able to move forward with it, it makes me that much more conscious of wanting to help people. That's it.
I love it. The end.
The end.
I don't cry.